asked you about Jesus, and you said to me, you're going to tell me about Jesus, you're going to prove the Christian religion is true, and you told me all, what you have told me literally in the last few seconds is, you're studying geophysics, is that right?
Yes.
You're studying geophysics, and your name is?
Robert.
Robert. So your name is Robert, you're studying geophysics at Imperial College, which is one of the top universities in the world. Okay, Robert, and you're going to prove to me, you're going to prove to me Christian religion is true. What sort of Christian are you, Catholic or?
I'm a Catholic.
You're a Catholic, and you're going to prove to me the Catholic religion is true. Brilliant. We'd love to hear that. Muslims want to know how is the Catholic religion true. Let me ask you one question to maybe make it easier for you. Do you believe Jesus is God or Jesus was sent by God?
I believe that Jesus was God, right. That God entered through like a human body, I guess. Into Jesus, and to show that in principle that the humankind is evil and sinful, because obviously he got killed for little or no reason at all. So
brilliant. So Jesus is God, you're saying, and Jesus God became Jesus and he died for our sins, you're saying, and we get salvation if we believe in this.
I mean, personally, I do. As I said, I'm not trying to prove that anything's right or wrong. Obviously, Muslims.
You believe the Catholics is correct.
I mean, I've been taught from little like that. Obviously, I'm from Poland, so we're all very Catholic from families. I would say that I'm a little less Catholic than my family in Poland, but.
But you're Catholic, nevertheless. Okay, and you're going to show us. Brilliant. Okay, you're going to show us why Islam is true. And your name is Albert, you said?
Robert, yes.
Robert. Okay, Robert. You said Jesus is God, okay? Robert, you're studying geophysics, a geophysicist. Can I say geophysicist?
Sure.
So you're a geophysicist from Imperial College, and you believe Jesus is God. Look, let me give you three characteristics of God and see what you think. Number one, God can do everything. Right. In the Bible, Jesus says, by myself, without God, also called the Father, I can do nothing. If he was God, he would say, I know everything. In the Bible, according to the Bible, Jesus said, when he was asked about the hour, he said, no one knows your hour, not the angels or the Son. In the Bible, Jesus called the Son of God. He said, only God knows, the Father knows. So Jesus said, I don't know, only God knows. Thirdly, if he was God, he would say, I am the highest, the Almighty. In the Bible, Jesus says, the Father, or God, is greater than me, greater than all. So we would say that with these three characteristics, if Jesus can do nothing without God, if Jesus doesn't know the hour, only God does, if Jesus says, I'm not the highest, God is the highest, how would say Jesus is not God, Robert?
To me, it seems like God would like kind of hide in Jesus to not show himself too much. For example, obviously, there's...
just to clarify that point here, just to make it short, because you said you only have a few minutes. Yeah. So you're saying God hid inside Jesus to not show too much about himself.
Exactly, to show.
So are you saying God hid inside Jesus and then started to lie?
Not really.
Because Jesus said, I don't know the hour.
I don't think it's lying. I think it's more like a misbelief. Like,
confusing here. One second. God knows everything. Can we agree?
Yes.
Okay, we agree. Muslims agree. Christians agree. Catholics agree. God knows everything. Jesus said, I don't know the hour.
Yes, because...
So how can he be God?
So to me, I mean, this is my perception, God came into Jesus, so Jesus is de facto God, but he doesn't want to show himself as God.
So he had to lie?
Corrupt him. Yeah, I guess it's...
So Jesus, God became Jesus, and he had to lie.
It's not really lying, it's more of like a misdirection.
No, one second. God knows everything. Jesus said, I don't know the hour, only God does.
Yeah.
So is he speaking the truth?
Yes and no, because as I said...
So you can't have yes and no.
Yeah, but it's
come closer, my friend, closer to the camera. No, you're saying that God... You agree God knows everything?
Yeah, I agree.
And you're saying Jesus is God?
Jesus says he doesn't know everything.
That means he can't be God then.
Why not?
Sorry, God knows everything, Jesus doesn't know everything, but he's still God.
It's not black and white, it's like...
It's grey and brown.
He's trying to show... that humans are sinful, right?
No, I'm confused. God knows everything.
I know what you're trying to do.
I'm saying that Jesus can't be God, my friend. Look, we're not trying to embarrass you, or look, we're not trying to do this. Okay, I would like to invite you to accept that Jesus is not God, he's sent by God. After Jesus, another man was sent by God. His name is Muhammad. How do we know Muhammad is a...
Tell me something. In the Muslim religion,
Yes. Is
God inside of you at all times? It's like
God is never inside us physically. God says inside the Quran, he's closer than to us than our jugular vein. Mm-hmm. Right. And so God is very close to us spiritually by his knowledge, etc. Okay, by his knowledge is very close to us, but he's not physically inside us. That's what we believe. Because obviously God doesn't get inside his creation. His creation is separate from the creator. Now, after Jesus, God sends another messenger. His name is Muhammad.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Robert, right? Mm-hmm. Robert. And how do we know that Muhammad is a messenger of God? By the way, this was predicted by Jesus. If you look at the Bible, Jesus says, I have many things to say to you. You cannot bear them now. When he, the Spirit of Truth, the Holy Spirit comes, what he says won't be from himself, but what he hears. So Jesus talked about the Holy Spirit bringing the words of God, who is called the Father in the Bible, to us. So where are these words of God, or you would call the Father, where are these words of God, or you would say the Father? These words are inside the Quran, right? Now let me show you very quickly why the Quran is a miracle. Why the Quran contains the words of God. It's a 1400-year-old book. Mm-hmm. Okay, Robert, it's unchanged in the Arabic language.
Because it doesn't like...
The
Bible has different versions, obviously.
Okay, so you're saying Bible has different versions, Quran has only got one version. Okay, let me continue. The Quran contains lots of statements about science.
Okay.
Thirdly, you're a scientist. You're a geophysicist. Thirdly, the Quran contains no scientific mistakes. Okay. Fourthly, the book is easy to memorize completely, and millions have memorized it in the Arabic language. Mm-hmm. And they can't even speak Arabic, like me. Five, it's one of the miracles of the Quran. Five, the Prophet Muhammad couldn't read and write.
Okay.
Right? It says that in the Quran, peace be upon him. And he's a shepherd looking after sheep. Mm-hmm. He gets a visitation by the Holy Spirit called an angel. In a cave, and these words kept coming down from God. Six, the words of the Quran have an effect of affecting your life, making you happy, right, making you positive, etc. Number seven, this book contains no contradictions, even though it was revealed a little bit at a time over 23 years. It came down over 23 years. Number eight, the way the Arabic language is used inside the Quran, Robert, it's very, very powerful and inimitable. Right. Number nine, it contains God's challenge. Inside the Quran, God says no one can ever write even three sentences like the Quran again. And that's a very arrogant statement. It's a mad statement for a human being to make. Only God can say it, and he has inside the Quran. Number 10, it's produced the largest practice religion. Islam is the largest.
It
is. Yes, it's the largest practice religion. You're surprised?
Yeah, I'm surprised because, I mean, then again,
if you include all the Christians, okay, how many Catholics in the world? About 1.6 billion Catholics in the world. Yeah, that's right. If you include all the Christians, there's about 2 billion Christians in the world, including Catholics. How many of these practice their religion? Very few.
Very few.
That's right. Yeah. With Islam is the largest practice religion because most Muslims pray. All Muslims pray, and it's just been Ramadan recently, and they all fasted. All the adults fasted.
You know?
That's right.
Okay. It's the fastest growing religion. Mm-hmm. Historical events inside the Quran, 100% accurate. Prophecies inside the Quran, 100% accurate. Other religions, how they started is describing the Quran, 100% correct. Quran contains an economic and a welfare system. Okay, what's the message in the Quran, Robert? The message in the Quran is there's one God. He's not male or female. We use the word Allah. The word Allah is gender neutral. Makes more sense than having God the Father having a son. Why not God the Mother having a daughter? Okay. Second point is, how do we get to God? Do you know what the Quran says? The true Muslims were people like Abraham, Moses, Jesus.
Okay.
And he's the Messiah. And he's the Word of God. So Jesus is the way to God. Like Muhammad, peace be upon him, and peace be upon Jesus. It's an inclusive message. Not an exclusive message. And it clearly, even if you follow Jesus in the Bible, Robert, I would suggest you would believe that he is somebody sent by God. He says, the Father has sent me. When he was leaving, Jesus says, I'm going back to my Father, your Father, my God, your God. He spent hours praying to God. He spent sometimes a whole night praying to God. If he was God, he wouldn't pray to God. I would suggest that he is somebody sent by God.
Okay. I mean,
can you accept that?
Yeah, I can accept that, obviously.
Perfect. You can accept. Okay, so you're a Catholic and you're accepting that Jesus is sent by God. Can you please accept Muhammad is the prophet of God as well?
Yes, of course, of course.
Okay. If you accept,
there's multiple prophets. There's Zachary as well. There's Saint John the Baptist.
So you're a Catholic. You said you're going to prove that Catholic is true in 10 minutes.
I'm not going to prove anything.
No. But now, what we're saying is, I would suggest, look, if you accept Muhammad is a prophet of God, what's the proof that Muhammad is a prophet of God? Miracle of the Quran. Clearly a powerful book, clearly a miracle. You agree?
Sure.
Congratulations, you're a Muslim. I would suggest you say two sentences, Robert, and you have a very powerful connection with the Creator. You say, I'm sure nothing should be worshipped except the highest power, Allah. The same words used by Jesus. Jesus used the word Allah for God. So you use the same word. So I'm sure nothing should be worshipped except the highest power. And secondly, you say, I am sure that Muhammad is his servant and his messenger, which you've already agreed.
That is for sure
true. Yeah. Then you'll be a Muslim, brother. Okay. Okay. Repeat the words. I am with.
No, repeat. No. I can accept.
No. So yeah, do you accept? Sorry, one second. If you come a bit closer because you're going too far away, you can accept.
Soon.
Okay, but no, we're all going soon. We're all leaving the world, my friend.
Yeah, for sure. That's why.
We're all leaving the world.
I need to make something useful out of the world.
Of course. Of course. No. No. Look, what I would say is, Robert, is, look, you're a geophysicist, right, Catholic. You're agreeing the Quran is from God. Yep.
Sure.
Yep.
You're agreeing that Muhammad, you're agreeing Jesus is sent by God. You said you can accept that?
I can accept it. I personally don't believe it, but it's
No. You said you can accept that he could be somebody sent by God.
I accept that I can be wrong, yes.
You accept it, but you can be wrong. That's fine. And you also, you said you accept Muhammad is a messenger of God.
Yes, he's a prophet indeed.
He's a prophet indeed. Brilliant. Robert, I would say you're a Muslim, brother. Congratulations. Can we give you a hug?
Okay. Brother, you're blessed.
You are a blessed man. Robert, you're a Muslim now. Now, what I would suggest you do, you don't need to tell anyone. Keep it secret. I mean, we might have a few million people watching, but don't worry about that. Do some prayers.
A few million.
A few million.
Nice.
Look, you're a Muslim. It's a very big thing. Okay, it's a very big thing. You're a Muslim now. I'll give you a book on how Jesus prayed by putting his head on the ground. Okay, and how Abraham and Moses prayed the same way Muhammad prayed, peace be upon all of them. And you're blessed. Robert, we say to you, Assalamu alaikum. You know this, Assalamu alaikum?
It's hello, no?
It means peace be upon you.
Peace be upon you.
Yeah, Jesus used to say in Aramaic and Hebrew, Shalom Aleichem.
Shalom Aleichem.
Yeah, that's right. The Jewish people say that. We say Assalamu Alaikum. Same words, same meaning. So congratulations, you're a Muslim. So you came here and you were going to, you're going to tell me how Catholic religion will save, but you're agreeing that Muhammad is a messenger of God.
I'm disagreeing to a different point of view, which
you
think
do.
It's totally acceptable.
Like, good. Congratulations, brother. Robert, geophysicist, welcome to Islam. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Okay, we'll give you books.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Innal ladhina qalu rabbuna Allah thumma istaqamu fala khawfun 'alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. أولئك أصحاب الجنة خالدين فيها جزاء بما كانوا يعملون.